Hi, I'm Kyle Randolph. I'm a product manager here at JumpCloud. Welcome to our tutorial video series.
In this video, we're going to be covering our directory integration with G Suite. To begin this process, I'm going to walk you through connecting JumpCloud and G Suite. Then, we're going to import a user from G Suite into JumpCloud. Then, we're going to change the information of that user in JumpCloud and see that propagate out directly from our platform into G Suite. After that, we'll cover disabling a user account in the JumpCloud platform and looking at the end impacts on the Google side. And finally, I'll walk through the process of creating a user account in the JumpCloud platform and have that propagate out into G Suite. Now, before we begin, you'll see that I have a few different windows open. We're going to be interacting with the JumpCloud admin console, the Google admin console, and then we're also going to be walking through that journey of importing and activating user accounts from the end user's perspective, in this case, using the user Alexander. So let's first navigate over into the JumpCloud platform, and we'll move down into directories. In the directories section, you'll see that we have directory level integrations with a variety of other resources or other directories. Though in this case, we're going to be focusing entirely on Google. And on the other side, it is important to note that in order to establish this connection between JumpCloud and Google, we need to enable API access on the Google side, as the directory integration that we're leveraging is an API-driven one. So we'll navigate to the Google admin section, and we'll go into security. And further, we'll scroll on down here to API reference, and we'll need to ensure that API access is enabled in order to allow this synchronization to occur. Next, we're going to move back over into the JumpCloud platform, and we'll pull open the G Suite aside. Now, you'll see here that my account is already been activated. However, in order to activate your directory integration with G Suite, you'll need to leverage a super admin level of credentials to establish this sync. Once you've done that, you'll see the side panel change from authorize the G Suite connection to the one that you see here in my platform. With both of those completed, you're now able to leverage the directory integration to perform all of those different functions that I mentioned earlier. So we'll start out with adding a new user into JumpCloud that already exists in the Google directory. So we'll select Import G Suite Users. Now, when I select the Import button, what this does is it takes us to the importation tool, from which I can either select and choose to import all users, or, in this case, I have a very particular user that I'd like to import, Alexander Mastodon. So I'll select Alexander, and now we'll scroll to the very bottom to import our user. And with that, I can see that Alexander has now been successfully added into the JumpCloud directory. So let's close out of this tool and take a look at what's going on in the JumpCloud side, or on the JumpCloud side. As I segue over to users and sort by status, I can see that my users actually have a variety of different statuses. The green check mark indicating that their accounts are active and everything is good. The orange circle with the dots indicating that the user account has not yet been activated, and red showing that the account has been locked out. Now, as we look at our user Alexander, we see that he's in this pending or inactive state. So let's talk through the activation process. The way this is done is by adding the user into the G Suite directory and saving. Now, the reason why we have this split up into a couple of steps is really to allow you as an administrator the ability to pause and educate your employees that they're going to be added into the JumpCloud directory. This gives them time to become familiarized with the JumpCloud platform, as well as let them know that they should be expecting to receive an email inviting them to complete their account setup, and further, that when they need to change their password, they'd be doing so in JumpCloud. So let's go ahead and trigger that email to send to our user, Alexander. So to complete that G Suite sync, we'll add them into the G Suite directory for that user, and we'll select Save. And now, as we go on to the Google side for our user, we can see that Alexander has a new email from JumpCloud waiting for him. If we open up that email, we can see that Alexander now has lots of helpful information letting him know that he's been added into the JumpCloud directory. And further to that, what is the end impacts for him? So what does the integration with G Suite and JumpCloud look like? And what can he do? Now in this case, let's go ahead and get that account activated. So we'll follow the Get Started link. And now I'm taken to a very important part for Alex. This is where he changes his password for the first time and gets his account active in JumpCloud. Now let's take a look at this from a couple different perspectives. The first is one where Alex doesn't add a password that really matches with the security settings that you've set or chosen as an administrator. So Alexander tried to enter a shorter password. And Twitch now, seeing that he entered an incorrect password or password that does not meet the complexity requirements, we can see that needs to be at least 8 characters or more and have lowercase, number, and uppercase letter. So let's go ahead and give Alex a new password that meets those complexity settings. And now we can see that it accepted that new password, and so Alexander can sign in to both the JumpCloud console, and if we refresh his page, we can see it actually signed him out. This is important to notice because what that means is he's now using his JumpCloud password to sign in. So the very same password I just set in JumpCloud, I'm going to re-enter here in the Enter Password field and hit Next. And with that, I can ensure that the password that Alexander is using to sign into his G Suite account is a secure one. Further, if we go back to the JumpCloud side and we look at our user Alex, we can see that his account is now in a active state. What this allows you as an admin is the ability to quickly and easily see, as we go back to that status view, who has and who has not yet activated their accounts. So that's the process of adding the user into the JumpCloud platform and activating it. Now let's segue over and let's take a look at another piece of Alex's account, the JumpCloud platform. So we're going to use the same credentials that Alex just used to sign into his G Suite account, and we're going to now sign into the JumpCloud user portal. In this user portal, I have a few things I can see. If Alexander was given access to any SSO applications, those would be appearing here. He can also navigate over to his profile, to which he can populate his contact information, modify both his home and work address. Or let's take a look at another piece. Let's say Alexander isn't that formal, actually prefers going by Alex. We can see how here in the platform, if Alex changes his name to Alex instead of Alexander, using that very same API integration that we have with G Suite, this name will now update in the Google Admin Console. So let's move over to the Google side, and we'll go to Users in the directory, and let's take a look at our user Alex. So you can see now that his name has even updated from Alexander to Alex. So even at the user level, your users can update their information and have that iterate from JumpCloud into Google. And the next piece that I'd like to show here is the way that you can leverage the JumpCloud platform to disable that user's account. So the same way that we added and completed that sync with Alex, we can now go back to directories. And if we deselect the G Suite directory and save, what this will do, as we can see we're being prompted here, is we're unbinding that user from the directory. And what that really is going to mean for Alex is it's going to put his account into a disabled state. So if we refresh the Google Admin console, we'll see his name no longer appears in the list of active users. So if we take a look even further at suspended users, we can see that Alex's account is now put in a suspended or disabled state. If we refresh the page once more for Alex on his personal account, we can see that he's once again been signed out. And if he tries to sign in, it'll appear in prompt noting that his account is disabled. And the last piece that I wanted to show in this integration that we have with G Suite is the process of creating a new user in JumpCloud and having that federate out into Google. So in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to select the plus icon, means of creating a new user in the JumpCloud platform, and we're going to create our new user, Roxana Johnson. One important thing to note here, as I'm entering in the email in particular, you must ensure that the domain you're specifying in JumpCloud matches with the one that you have configured on the Google side, else you'll fail in creating that new user account. Though, in this case, we're in the demo JumpCloud domain. We've got our user set up, Roxana Johnson, and we're going to segue down. In this case, what I'd like to do is I want to give Roxana a temporary password to help with creating her account. And just like we did with Alex to complete that sync, now we're going to go back over to the G Suite directory, and we're going to add Roxana to that directory. Now, when I select save, what's occurring here is using that same API integration we've leveraged with our previous user, Alex, it is now going through to create a new user, Roxana. So we'll refresh the page. And now we'll do a search, to which we can see that we have a new user, Roxana Johnson, who was just created using the JumpCloud directory and further our G Suite directory integration. Now, to recap, we first covered the process of establishing a connection between JumpCloud and G Suite using the super admin credential set. Then, we proceeded to import our new user, Alex Macedon, from the G Suite directory into the JumpCloud platform. Then we covered how that user, Alexander, could update his information to Alex and have that propagate from JumpCloud into G Suite. Then we covered disabling his account in the JumpCloud platform. And finally, we covered the process of creating new user accounts from JumpCloud and having those federate directly into G Suite. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. If you'd like to learn more about this topic, please navigate to support.jumpcloud.com. If you'd like to reach out to someone directly, you can email us at info@jumpcloud.com. And finally, if you'd like to stay current with our upcoming videos, click subscribe.